Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My brothers, my sisters in Islam, we are here back together. Alhamdulillah, my dear Sheikh Dr. Muhammad Salah, Mufti Ismail Ming. We are in the Philippines. We had a beautiful event last night, Connecting the Pearls conference. Alhamdulillah, the theme was about introducing
11th edition.
The 11th year. Alhamdulillah, mashallah. We've been together for more mashallah than that, actually. But in the Philippines alone, we've been coming together, alhamdulillah. Same speakers, we never changed, alhamdulillah. We have more mashaykh will come and go, but alhamdulillah, the three of us being together for this bunch. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reunite us once more, inshallah, with Al-Habib Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannat al-Firdaus. We are about to leave. Mufti Min, can you explain what's happening in the next couple of days, inshallah?
So basically, inshallah, azza wa jal, today we are going to be leaving from here.
Do you want to go out to show the people?
Yeah. Today we will be leaving from here, Manila, going to a place called Gensan, General Santos. General Santos is a city. You want people to open it back?
Yes.
Yeah.
So General Santos is?
So basically today we are going to General Santos and we're driving from there about 2 hours to a place called Sultan Kudrat. There are two Sultan Kudrats in the Philippines. They are not too far from each other, but
one is the province, one is the city.
Yes, one is the province, one is the city.
So the one which we visited last year or not visited?
No, we're not visiting.
Unfortunately, that was the city. We are going now to the province itself. And this was, inshallah, because we have a series of events, this is going to be the largest in terms of attendance, inshallah.
Yeah. And so,
and since there are no flights.
Yes, the mayor from the other Sultan Kudrat was there at our event last night, Dato Tukau.
Him and his family.
Him and his family, and his son is the deputy
governor
of the vice governor of the area. So alhamdulillah, then we will have our event in Sultan Kudrat, and then we will be leaving inshallah, again flying out
to
Zamboanga. And when we fly to Zamboanga inshallah, we have an event there. We have people to meet our brother Rauf. May Allah grant him Jannah. He's the one who initiated that in a beautiful way. He helped us a lot. May Allah give him Jannah and help him.
I was very pleased. Last year we made it to visit his grave.
Yes, last year we visited his grave.
And also we don't forget our brother Sheikh Ahmed Javier as well. May Allah have mercy on him.
Yes, and then from there we will fly out to Tawi Tawi, which is the furthest point of the south of the Philippines. Tawi Tawi, we've never been there before. It used to be a slightly dangerous area before.
Yes. Still, there are concerns about some conflict, and that's why, alhamdulillah, we always insist to go to those areas with, of course, you know, advice.
The youth in these conflict areas are much in need for speakers and dua.
You need to encourage them.
Go and actually assist them.
One of the things I noticed is that when we go and gather a large number of Muslims, it really gives the people a reassurance regarding their identity as Muslims, because people are actually fighting the identity of Muslims. They want you to be embarrassed. They want you not to practice. They want you not to wear your hijab. They want you to feel uncomfortable with a few of these things.
And so actually, our presence is more than just giving talks and leaving.
Yes.
Reassurance to people.
We want to empower them. You know, when you see a large number of Muslims, mashallah, as a Muslim, it gives you a reassurance. Alhamdulillah.
At one point, people didn't believe that we would be in Marawi. We will go to the Marawi. Next time we go to Marawi with Dr. Salah, he didn't make it there. Zamboanga was off the list. People never thought, especially after the shooting of Dr. Aad al-Qarni. And also this time, Tawi Tawi,
it's a surprise. That we need to share with people. We're not even from the Philippines. We don't only go to the UK, USA, Washington DC, and Toronto in Canada, and here and there, but we, alhamdulillah, we go even to the jungles.
Alhamdulillah, and don't be fooled by the private jets and private planes. These are provided by the mayors and the governors of Maguindanao and other provinces who are Muslims, alhamdulillah, and they always... Yeah, and there's no flights, actually. So in order for us to actually have all these events in 3-4 days, private planes will be, inshallah ta'ala, at our disposal. So pray for the mayors who provided this. Pray for us. It's not easy. Or don't think that because we're flying on private jets, it's something easy.
No, it's tough. It's very tough. I mean, you gotta get up early morning, work whole day, evening. Sometimes we, are restricted regarding our...
Sleep for a couple of hours.
Yes. But inshallah, a few days and we will be okay. I normally say, even if it takes hours and we're tired, for as long as you have good company and you're doing the right thing, fisabilillah, you wouldn't mind.
Alhamdulillah. We were talking about how Filipinos in general, their hearts are so inclined to the deen, even non-Muslims among them. When they hear the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you find them crying, you find them coming backstage and you know, declaring the faith in Islam. The Quran mentions something about this. Can you, Doctor, elaborate?
Allah Almighty says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, chapter number 5, وَلَتَجِدَنَّ أَقْرَبَهُمْ مَوَدَّةً لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّا نَصَارَى ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ مِنْهُمْ قِسِّيسِينَ وَرُهْبَانًا وَأَنَّهُمْ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. So Allah Almighty said, among the people of the book, the nearest to the believers and the most compassionate are those who say we are the followers of Jesus, peace be upon him, and supporting him. They have priests, they have religious leaders, and they're not arrogant. Subhanallah.
This is very important quality, not being arrogant.
They are not arrogant, and this is arrogance is the greatest hindrances against accepting the truth. That's why in the sound hadith, Rasulullah, peace be upon him, said, one who have even an atom weight of arrogance shall not enter paradise. Mm. One would wonder, an atom weight of arrogance will prevent a person from entering heaven? Yes, because when he was asked what is arrogance, he said, it is batar al-haqqi
wa lamtun nas,
rejecting the truth and looking down at people. So if a person have this evil trait of arrogance, even if he has the Quran speaking to him, he will not see it. Versus a person, even if he's not Muslim, but he's humble and he's willing to accept the truth. Once he lays his eyes on the word of Allah, I have some people, Christian people, wallahi accepted Islam by mere reading Surah Al-Fatiha. I have a Christian missionary, by reading Surah Al-Fatiha, accepted Islam right away. She said, this is the truth. This is what I've been
looking
for.
I remember a sister was reading Surah Maryam. I was reciting and giving the translation. She said, no, this is in my Bible. I said, no, this is a surah. The whole chapter in the Quran is named after, Maryam, the mother of Jesus. And based on those ayat, when she realized it's in the Quran, she accepted Islam. Alhamdulillah.
And the ayat goes on and it says, وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ تَرَى أَعْيُنَهُمْ تَفِيضُ مِنَ الدَّمْعِ مِمَّا عَرَفُوا مِنَ الْحَقِّ.
When they hear what is revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you find their eyes filled with tears because they recognize the truth. Those are the knowledgeable and those are the ones who do not have pride. Yes. And this is why when you want guidance from Allah, if you have pride in your heart, chances are it will either be delayed or it won't come, because you despise people and you will reject the truth anyway. So even if it comes towards you, you won't recognize it. And if you do recognize it, your arrogance will want to reject it. So many people, like at the time of the Prophet, Allah says, وَلَكِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ يَجَحَدُونَ. The wrongdoers, they denied the signs of Allah, the verses of Allah.
That is in Surah Al-An'am, chapter number 6.
Yes, they knew the truth.
قَدْ نَعْلَمُ إِنَّهُ لَيَحْزُنُكَ الَّذِي يَقُولُونَ فَإِنَّهُمْ لَا يُكَذِّبُونَ وَلَكِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ يَجَحَدُونَ.
So they know it's the truth, but they rejected for worldly reasons.
Why? Because of arrogance.
Yes.
Abu Jahl, Al-Akhnas ibn Shurayq, and all these people who were there at the time.
And you know about the Pharaoh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَجَحَدُوا بِهَا وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ ظُلْمًا وَعُلُوًا. So they were certain that the signs that Musa alayhi salam was given and the miracles were true miracles.
Certain.
And this verse, it actually means these people denied it. Jahadu biha. They refused, rejected, and denied.
Out of arrogance.
So, themselves, they knew that this was the truth. Why? Zulman wa uluwan. Because of pride and because of wrongdoing.
Something very important people I think need to know is that we are not here to convert the Christians. This is not our mission. Our mission is to really share what we believe about our faith. And if people come forward on their own accord,
by the way,
on their own.
By the way, not only here or there,
everywhere,
but simply, you don't convert no one.
This is not Islam's mission.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is Islam's mission.
Okay.
But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Surah Al-Qasas, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتِ. You do not convert nor guide whom you like. It is Allah who guides whoever
he
wants.
No, I mean the mission is to convey, not to convert.
The mission is always to convey and also to reassure and empower the young Muslims. Muslims and the upcoming and the weak to say, you know what, your identity, inshallah, you should not compromise. Be a proud Muslim in the sense that be a happy, good, practicing Muslim, open. So what if they don't like a few things about you? They don't like a few things about all of us. I think they are ready to leave.
MashaAllah, inshallah,
we'll
be inshallah in touch. Jazakallah khair. Include us all in your dua. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi
wa barakatuh.